it got the whole class in their own little clique talking about politics. And my professor walked in, my welding professor, and he said, I don't even want to know, because everybody had started clapping, Alex. They weren't clapping for me. They were clapping against me. They were tired of hearing my political dissidents, and they hated me, Alex. But I tried to leave. I went to my professor, and I told him, I can't do this. You're trying to suppress my pursuit of happiness. I only want to talk about life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. I'm just not mature enough to go a single day without talking about my passions. And they told me I couldn't do it. And I packed up my stuff, and I tried to leave.
Well, I want
to
explain how this works. You shouldn't let them win. And I get once class starts, you can't be disruptive, and it's not. And it wasn't a political class. I would do it on the grounds, at lunch, in the parking lot, the folks you talk to. But it does show the mindset of people where in a group, they get a thrill out of shutting speech down. And they're going to enjoy when their bank accounts are taken. They're going to enjoy when they're forcibly inoculated. But they've been taught groupthink and the power of hissing and shouting somebody down. Good to hear from you. But, you know, you can't be disruptive. I'm not saying you were disruptive. But you're saying you packed up yourself and left because of it. I'm not saying you're in the wrong. I think they're in the wrong. But you've got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, know when to run. Never count your money when you're sitting at the table. They'll be calm enough for counting when the dealing's done. Let's go ahead and talk to Mike in Illinois. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Nice to talk to you again. I've spent some time researching this, and I've kind of written it out. So let me just spit it out real quick, and I want your opinion on it. If people think what's been done in this country under the current administration is bad, it's what is yet to come that we need to keep our eye on. Ultimately, it'll be the people as a whole that'll either stop or participate in the demise of this country. All the perversion and anti-American activity that's been pushed or displayed to the population is being done with a purpose. If we look back just 70 years ago, we can see why. In Germany, prior to the adoption of National Socialism, the country was comprised of two-thirds Protestants and one-third Catholic. They were essentially a Christian nation. Coming into the 1930s and before the rise of Hitler, Germany was considered the most socially progressive country in Europe. Open homosexuality, transgendered persons, the whole cabaret culture was adopted and thrust upon the population.
The roaring 20s, it became super party time.
Correct. By the types of people that we would call liberals today. In fact, the first recorded male-to-female gender reassignment surgery occurred in Berlin in 1931. This type of activity and behavior was hefted upon the average German who was tolerant because of their Christian foundations.
No, exactly. True Christians are susceptible because we are so open and free, and then we are taken over by other cults.
Correct. So having this thrown in front of their face over and over and over again, they saw it as destroying their traditional value system and were watching it being thrust upon their children. It was grinding on the psyche of the average German citizen, much like is happening in the United States today. Then suddenly a tough-talking guy comes on the scene speaking in populist language about restoring the greatness of Germany, knowing exactly this is exactly what the average citizen desired. One of the first actions taken to return Germany to greatness was the Reichstag fire decree, which I know you are totally familiar with.
Yeah, false flag. Then Hitler had all the homosexuals in the SA rounded up and killed, and not of the long knives. That pleased the public.
I'll just fast forward ahead so we can skip a lot of it. But the Reichstag fire decree opened up all sorts of restrictions on personal liberty, rights of freedom of expression. It even allowed for postal, telephonic, and telegraphic communications to be eavesdropped on. I mean, it's a mirror of what happened with the Patriot Act. After that, they started with the book burning, which was literally the burning of pornography and associated materials and textbooks that were viewed as the source of the perversion
in
the society.
And once they set that precedent, then they could ban all other criticism.
It got worse and worse and worse. Then the roundups began. And once they started concentrating people in ghettos and rounding people up, the browbeaten population was now effectively scared into submission.
And they started having lockdowns of ghettos and checkpoints only in select areas to condition the public. Same thing now.
Absolutely. At this point, their submission and worship of God was transformed into submission and worship of the state, and the groundwork was laid for all hell to break loose. So as scary as the shift under the current political leadership in America is, it's the rapid and extreme movement in the other direction that we should all be acutely aware of. The people are ready to support anyone who's willing to get the job done, and this is the point where, as Joseph Stalin said, decades can happen in weeks. swinging this country so far in the other direction that we'll find ourselves quickly on the wrong side of history. We have a stunningly ignorant, browbeaten population crying out for a strong leader to restore the greatness of America. We have the legal framework of control in place. We have dozens of groups from preppers and patriots to transgendered persons who have arrogantly identified themselves thanks to pop culture encouragement through TV and whatnot. The surveillance structure that's in place to catalog everybody so they know who's a threat before they ever take a move.
And that's Jade Helm.
It's all sorts of things that have been going on. We have religious, ethnic, and other minorities that have been blamed for every ill possible, proudly identifying themselves. We have leaders emerging who are pitching populist messages with a get-it-done attitude who will pledge to restore the greatness of the United States. Everything is in place. We just need the right leader and another catalyst event, and we're going to be in deep trouble. One has to ask themselves if, for instance, the Republican tough guy candidate with the populist rhetoric, if he were to be elected and with his get-it-done attitude wanted to round up and deport ethnic or religious minorities like Hispanics and Muslims, how many people in today's society would really oppose
it? A lot of folks would go for it, and then he'd have the precedence to do it to everybody.
Absolutely. So once that starts, how is the voice of reason ever going to stop it? The bottom line is one man is not going to fix the mess in this country. He will only act to lead us all to our own demise. The only way to fix this is for the people themselves to find it in their gut to stand up and speak out. Thank you for letting me get that out.
Sure. Let me say this, Mike. You wrote that, didn't you? Because, I mean, that was well written.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what website is that on? What did you write that for?
I wrote it last night. I emailed a rough copy to David Knight. I was busy when I wrote it.
Well, I know this. I was sent some other great stuff from an investment banker I met in the Cayman Islands. I read it this morning. Meant to give it to the webmaster to post. I didn't. I'm going to give that to some of the guys during the break. I just forget. There's so much going on. What you wrote really sounds great, so why don't you send it to showtips@infowars.com, and we'll post it. Absolutely. The danger of the extremist leftist takeover right now is real. So I'm fully opposing the Democrats. If the Republicans start acting fascist and there's some guy on a white horse, I will then oppose them. It appears the globalists worldwide, though, are afraid of fascist movements, and they're going with liberal, socialist, communist-styled movements. But this is so outrageous that it makes me wonder if they're trying to condition us to accept a fascist curveball. And so I think what you're saying is very, very important. In fact, we'll take this five-minute call and put it up as its own video. I think it's very informative. What would you call it? Parallels from Nazi Germany to America? Or beware the man on a white horse? What should we call this piece, Mike?
I'm just honored that you would do it.
No, sure, but we'll put your article up. But I mean, what I'm asking is, what would you call this last 5 minutes? That the political climate is ready for fascism?
I liked your first line better because the parallels, they're almost done. You can't ignore them. They're so blatantly obvious.
Well, the same British social engineers that set Germany up are setting the U.S. up. And I'm not saying Britain runs it, but their systems of control with the British Empire are the most sophisticated. And it's all declassified. Man, they put Hitler in. They set him up. They had secret treaties. He was hanging out with the King of England. He thought that he was playing the bad cop for him. Then England was going to come in and with the U.S. and go after the Russians. They double-crossed him, started giving weapons to Russia. He turned in Operation Barbarossa. And so I'm not saying Hitler was a good guy. He was crazy and really bad, but he thought he was good. And, man, look how he got set up. And the Germans were smart, but they just could not deal with the super, you know, fifth-dimensional level, fourth-dimensional level chess that British intelligence plays. I mean, it's nasty, it's sickening, it's filthy, it's evil, and it's what the British developed in 1,000 years of war with their neighbors. And it's just a system of a map of false reality, and it's a great crime. I appreciate your call, Mike. We're going to go to break and do 5 minutes overdrive. Then the whole next hour is coming up with Anthony Gucciardi. Paul Watson has a sore throat today. He'll be in tomorrow. In the fourth hour of Overdrive, the wrap-up show where they cover what we covered on the show and the latest developments, Anthony Gucciardi will be hosting the fourth hour today, breaking down some breaking news, including new claims that ISIS could soon have nuclear capabilities. The globals could set off a nuke and bring in martial law and claim ISIS did it. The latest videos from today that we haven't gotten to and much more. Paul Watson will also be popping in to talk about what's coming up on tomorrow's show. Yes, Paul Watson is hosting tomorrow because my son is now 13. And I've only taken him hunting probably 15 times. I'd been hunting 15, 20 times by the time I was 7. So I'm taking my son dove hunting tomorrow. I do intend to shoot a report in the morning. That'll be part of the show with the latest, but I am taking my son hunting tomorrow outside Austin with my father and others. So it's just got to happen. I can say God's laid it on my heart, but it's just in my gut. I need to spend more time with my children, and I'm going to be doing that. But the nightly news is tonight, 7 o'clock as well. But Paul Watson will be hosting the entire first 3 hours tomorrow, and then I'm not sure who's doing the fourth hour tomorrow. Before we end this hour, incredible liver shield sold out for months. Then a limited supply came back in. The full shipment came in. It is one of the hottest items ever. You can learn about Liver Shield for daily use or Liver Shield with a deep cleanse. Deep cleanse did sell out. We do have the Child Ease, a lot of their products that are back in. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. We can call and answer all your questions, and your purchases fund the operation. Stay with us, fourth hour. Some stations don't carry it. InfoWars.com/show. Right, I literally come from you in deep in the heart of Texas from FEMA Region 6 in occupied territory. Hey, we should come in with a Red Dawn intro with Anthony Gucciardi in the next segment. Let's jam in some more calls. Denise in Texas, FEMA Region 6. Thanks for holding her on the air.
Hey, thanks, Alex. Thanks for taking my calls. Listen, the Pope, I wanted to talk about it because I was listening to your insider from Italy there, and he seemed a little over-the-top demonizing the Pope, and it makes me think, like, you know, this kind of worship that we saw that was scary and all the bright faces, millions of them out there, just for a little tiny glimpse of the Pope and the adulation and all this, and then him demonizing, and you have to go, okay, wait a minute, like, look at this from a PR perspective. Back in 2000, the Vatican published a study, and they expected their major growth in the next millennia to be from Latin America. Now, they're putting all their Catholic charities' efforts pretty much towards building that population, including, yes, bringing them here so it finances on our back. That also keeps their base here because, being conservative, they lost a lot of people with, you know, their stance against birth control.
No, I get it. Acting liberal, they can sell. We need to educate Latin Americans that communism is a Ford Foundation weapon to keep them down. And look, I may have gone too far in some cases going after the Pope, because I feel guilty that I didn't criticize some of the political aspects of Catholicism previously enough. And then now it's so naked that it's got to be exposed. I can see the temporal political things that the Pope's doing from the perspective of the Catholic Church. But if the Catholic Church continues on as a globalist organ, it really died. It doesn't survive. You see what I'm saying?
I think what it's going to be doing, though, is looking to align itself with whoever is globalism out there. And right now, I think that that's the fact that your insider from there is saying that, you know, Putin, he's casting Putin as like an, you know, the outsider against globalism. I think that's not so. I think that it's up for grabs, and that's why, you know, Russia and Iran are aligning and the
Pope. Oh, you're right. There is a major global power struggle about who will dominate a new bipolar world, moving from a unipolar world where the United States was the center of power.
Well, the thing is, China never got factored in, and now you see they're stepping up with Russia, and it's been going on for more than a decade, you know.
Yeah, well, it took hard work by the people running the U.S. to drive Russia and China into each other's arms and screw up the U.S. I mean, I'm saying this is sabotage by design, what they're doing. I appreciate your call. God bless you. Our government is running Al-Qaeda and ISIS. The whole world's learning about it. To hurt the United States. The globalists want to bring this country down, and they're doing it from within and without, and it makes me want to throw up. What scum traitors. Randy in Texas, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yes, Alex, now that you've got a satellite uplink, are you going to try to get the show on DirecTV or Dish Network?
Yes, I have just been resting since getting all this launched. We already have some TV stations and cable systems picking it up. Now I've got to start the drive to promote that to the stations to get it picked up and then to reach other platforms. So, yes.
Okay, that's all I wanted to know. Thank you very much, Alex, and keep up the good work.
God bless you, Randy. Thanks for putting up with me. Believe me, half the time I sound like a babbling idiot up here because it's exhausting, but at least I mean well. Alex in Kentucky, last caller. Sorry to the others. Go ahead.
for taking my call. I wanted to say that I've seen, since I've been watching you, maybe the past 4 months, there's been more attacks about Alex Jones, about your website, about all these stupid things that you're a Russian agent or a Zionist.